And as you heard from Brenda, the emphasis from Governor Murphy today is that those long-term school closures are inevitable. And although kids seem to be more resistant to the novel coronavirus, health experts say shutdowns can be an effective means for containing the spread.
As of this morning, a total of 354 total school districts have made the decision to close.
With each day, a new set of closures. Today, Education Commissioner Lamont Repillette sharing unprecedented details. 354 districts closing or closed. 90 districts shut due to concerns about potential exposure to COVID-19. 4 closed due to confirmed exposure. And 1 district has a presumptive or confirmed positive case of the coronavirus.
We have collected emergency plans from 307 school districts detailing the plans they have in place to continue providing education for our students. Many districts have taken professional development days to prepare for school closures.
The State Department of Education is coordinating with agencies to help provide child care and meals for students who rely on breakfast and lunch programs. Governor Murphy said today that's the key reason he's not mandating a statewide shutdown. 15% of public school districts don't have a food plan for students in need.
That's over 200,000 kids. I believe you did a survey of, not food, but remote learning and the ability to remote learn. And how many kids have a device? We all assume everybody's got a device. Guess what? The survey came back of 1,400,000 kids, 259,000 of them don't have devices. So when we talk about taking a step like this, it's not that we don't think it's a smart thing to do, but you got to do it responsibly.
School faculty and staff have been preparing digital lessons or plain old paper packets for those without internet service. In Jersey City, a district-wide shutdown will begin Monday. It's the state's second largest public school system.
We upload the Google Classroom model, and with the Google Classroom model, it provides a lesson, it provides an assessment, it provides even interaction with a teacher by way of text. And so under those circumstances, it replicas almost like a classroom structure, very similarly, so that students feel like they're being engaged in the process. But we have 21 sites that will be available to serve breakfast, provide lunch, and even dinner meals for our students. And it's going to be in a grab-and-go format, but those sites will be available for all of our students.
But spring is a critical time of year. Finals, AP exams, SATs, college applications. How will the schools keep up?
It's going to be an enormous challenge for New Jersey schools. There's a lot of unanswered questions on in terms of how lessons are even going to be delivered, what kind of effectiveness there'll be. Are these going to be 1 or 2 week extended closures, or could it go even longer than that?
Certainly, that's the question. And I can tell you, Mary Alice, that I've heard already from a number of teachers and parents who are concerned about having their own children home while they need to be teaching their students. It's going to be a very interesting situation. The governor said today that staff will be meeting and developing that game plan rather quickly, looking to make sure no student or family falls behind in the process.